What is going on, guys? Panther here, and we are bringing you our APA playoff analysis. So we have completed the comeback in a huge part to our front office, and especially Jacob, as always. So big shout out to him. And we have clinched playoffs here at the time of me recording this video. Week 12 is still going on as I'm recording this. I'm leaving on vacation. I come back the day that this is uploaded, actually. So by then, I will not only know who I play, but also know the results of my week one game, or my round one game. Jacob will be playing that game for me. I will be out of the country with no internet access. I will be dead to Discord during this time. So hopefully he's able to pull out a nice dub for us. So we're locked into the seventh seed. Not a great seeding for us, but at this point, we're almost assuredly guaranteed to play A-Drive or Gator. It's more than likely going to be Gator at this point. So yeah, hopefully we can pull out this dub. So I had a lot of different mons I could choose from tier one. I had Celesteela, Latios, Kartana, Garchomp, Keldeo, just to name some of the mons that I had this season. So Celesteela felt like a very good starting point to pick up and build around. Also would like to thank Gypsy for his feedback on the team as well. So hopefully I've got some big shoes to fill. He's the defending champ, and of course not in this league, so hopefully I can, you know, use some of that Gypsy power and take this thing home. Anyways, so we've got Celesteela here. Another small before I get into Celesteela. Big shout out to Mid Pokemaster for the slides here. Really coming through, saving me on such short notice before I go on my vacation. So anyways, yeah, we've got Celesteela here, and obviously Celesteela needs no introduction. It's one of the top mons in draft league format. It can do so many different things. It serves a defensive role so well. It can serve as an offensive mon, of course, as well. Autonomized sweeper. It just does a lot of things really, really well. It can be really hard for your opponent to break through. And if you can build around it good enough, then you're going to put your opponent in a really bad position. So we want to support it and check fire types, check those electric types. And I really feel like through our draft, you'll be able to see how we've done that. So one of the first mons I knew from tier two that I wanted us to pick up to help support our Celesteela, to help check those fire types, is the best water type in draft league format, and that is Suicune. Suicune is a Pokemon that can just win games alone. It forces a lot of prep. It gets a little stally. It isn't always the funnest to watch PP stalling things out, but Suicune does what it does so well. It's so bulky, it sponges hits, and it can be such a threatening sweeper. Like Vinkoon, just protect, sub, calm mind, scald. Like Krokoon with just like rest. So even if you status it, it can just boost up on you. You can EV it to live almost any hit, even Z moves, and just really just be a check to huge threats overall. This is just such a great mon, and I felt like it could really be just a great win con. Two, it could be a great switch in to, like I said, those fire types, sponging hits with leftovers and protect, just stalling out fire blast, stalling out, you know, any mon that has a move that, you know, has 8 or 12 PP can just really just wear him down. So I felt like Suicune was a great starting point to pair with Celesteela. Now I want to be able to check those electric types, and I want to get one of the best mons from tier 3, and that is Crocodile. Crook gives me a dark type, which is going to pair so well with our Mega later. It also gives me an electric immunity. It gives me a stealth rocker. Crook's one of the top mons from tier 3. A lot of leagues have it in tier 2. It's just a really solid mon. There's really nothing else to say. It's going to block that Volt Switch spam. And, you know, it's weak to, Suicune and Celesteela cover perfectly. So, like, grass types, Celesteela's going to cover. Fairy types, Celesteela's going to cover. Bug type, Celesteela's going to cover. Water type, Suicune's going to cover. So, I mean, it just pairs really well with these guys. Really, it's only weak to fighting, which these two... I do have a bit of a fighting weakness, as you'll see, but there's not going to be that many fighting types in this. There's no Mega Gallades. There may be one Mega Gallade, I think, potentially. There's no, like, Mega Metachams. There may be a Mega Lop or two. but Lop's significantly weaker, and Suicune and Celesteela can do a fair job of checking them, as well as my fairy that you're going to soon see. It doesn't have that immediate wall-breaking presence that that Gallade and Medicham have. So I felt like Crook was definitely the way to go over like Garchomp or over like Hippowdon, which were my other ground type options. Also, some more of my tier 3 options were like Lycanroc Dusk, Darmanitan, Decidueye, Alolan Muk. I felt like Crook was the best value from the tier. So dipping into tier 4. Tier 4 was slim pickings for me. I had Talonflame, Swellow, actually, we're on tier 3 again. So here's my other tier 3 first. Let me go ahead and show you that. That's Aerodactyl. Now, that may be a little bit of a surprise to see when I have mons like Darmanitan and Alolan Muk and Decidueye down there, but I felt like Aerodactyl gave me the most of what I was looking for opposing flying types. So I don't want to put all that pressure on Celesteela. A lot of teams have Tornaduses, and Aerodactyl was really a good mon to help me combat that. It's going to naturally outspeed the Torns, and it's going to be able to come in on those Fly Z moves and those Hurricanes, be able to sponge those and just roost off that damage, or maybe even Pursuit Trap it if I have it low. I felt like Aero gave me the best value for what I saw that could potentially be out there. Adds another flying type, of course, which also also helped sway my opinion down in tier 4 away from like Talonflame and Swellow, but Aerodactyl I felt like gave me the most consistency for my team here at that point. So in tier 4, this was pretty much a no-brainer here. This was one of the mons that gave me the most glue here on the team, and that's Rotom Moe. Gave me a Defogger other than Aerodactyl, of course. Gives me Volt Switch. Gives me another ground immunity. Not that I'm particularly ground weak or anything like that, but now I'm definitely not ground weak. Of course, Rotom's just a really solid mon in Tier 4. It can hit very hard. Gives me, of course, a bit of a drawback with my only Grass-type move. And I'm going to be really reliant on this thing to help me break opposing bulky waters, because that not only is that my grass type, but it's my water type too. So I'm going to really, really depend on this thing to come in. So we could expect to see Z moves on this thing if it's coming. But we have that flexibility and that benefit there of putting Grass EMZ on it and being able to click Bloom Doom then into Leaf Storm if need be. This was also a no-brainer down in Tier 5. This is a real steal down there. That's Big Miltank. Gives me another rocker again to not put that pressure on Aerodactyl and Crook. Gives me a wall. Gives me a thick fat mon to help me out with Celesteela, to help me out with Rotom. Help me out with my ice weakness, as you can see, because my steel doesn't resist ice. So Miltank's just a very solid mon. It's a great value in Tier 5, and I felt like it gave me the most for the team. Now this next bit is a bit funny. So when Mid was doing these slides, it was pretty late at night, and you're about to see the Mega I'm bringing, and that is Megalot Bunny. As you can see, Miltank's picture is still up there, but no worries there on that. It's Megalop. We decided to build around Megalop. Our options were Mega Alakazam, Megalop, and Mega Aggron. So Lop definitely gave me the most there. Alakazam would have been a fair choice, but Lop definitely gave me the most. Lop Bunny's just a very good Mega overall. Gives me a great speed tier. And then his dual stab just hits so hard. It just doesn't have a resist with Scrappy. Fairy types are the resist, and I have a Celesteela. So I'm not too worried about it, to be honest. I have a Celesteela, so those fairies can run electric or fire type moves for Celly, but you know, I can run a damage resist fairy, or if I get it in, I could potentially set up on with like Autotomize weakness policy or something like that. I can take advantage of fairies that are defensively built that may have coverage for Celesteela. So Lob Bunny, I felt like gave me the most for my team there. So diving in, I had enough points for a tier 1, a tier 2, a tier 4, and a tier 5. And I really felt like this other tier 1 was just an easy choice. I loved using Kartana. I loved using Garchomp. Garchomp was the kill leader for the first four section of the season. It was the MVP. Nobody. I didn't have anybody anywhere near the top in the second half, but in the third half, the third quarter, third, I led with Cartana with 11 kills and 40 trophies in 3 games, which is wild. Cartana just tore things up. I loved using it. I'm going to draft it again soon. I'm going to draft it again in Gen 7. Next Wi-Fi league I do, I've got to make it happen, because I've only gotten to use Cartana for 4 total games, and I loved it. But the mon that paired the best with Celesteela, gave me the most bang for my buck, was Latios. Latios is another great mon that I have. I've really enjoyed using it. It just hits so hard. And as you saw against Mydicus, it's just dual stab is so hard to switch into. That Dragon Psychic, even if you're a steel type, my team pressure steals with Crocodile and Lop Bunny. Lop is going to hit you hard, especially with like Soldew or Specs or my Z move. I keep calling it Lop. Latios is going to tear you up. And I'm really excited about using Big Blue here for my potential playoff run here. I want this championship, guys. I've never won it in APA Wi-Fi. I've won many in APA Showdown. I want this championship here, here in Gen 7. I want to beat some of the best battlers around. I want to take this thing home, and I feel like Latios can open the door for me here. Another tier 2 mon was a fairy type. Another debatable, you know, tier 2 mon overall. And that's Sylveon. Sylveon is a mon that I love. I use it in P4G Next Generation. So bulky, you can EV it to live defensive hits. EV it to live spadef hits. It's already naturally pretty spadef with 130 special defense, but it just does its job so well. So well. Then we have our boy Drapion here. I wanted a poison type. I wanted to go Weezing out of tier 5, but I figured a grounded poison type would be a little bit better, so it's not forcing me to defog or spin. I don't have spin, but defog away opposing toxic spikes. This gives me toxic spikes. This gives me another dark type for Lop Bunny as well. So if they want to bring Reuniclus or Mew or whoever, Drapion here can handle them. And then finally here, with the last mon on the team, we have a spinner. I forgot we even picked this thing up. It was Cryogonal. Our options were Lantern, Scyther, or Cryogonal here at this point. Maybe like somebody else I'm forgetting. But we decided to go with big Cryogonal here. It put in work the one game it came to. It did its job very well, got rid of hazards, and it was able to get some damage off on something. So it did what it was designed to do there that game. Gives me another ground immunity. I think Cryogonal hits a really good speed tier, and it's a pretty good value to be tier 5. It has a really high spadef. Obviously, it's not very defensive on the physical side, but it's able to make up for some of that. It gives me another ice resist, something else that'll pair well with Latios as well. So that's the playoff team, guys. I hope you guys are looking forward to it. 3 wins. 3 wins separates us from glory, and our fate is in the hands of Jacob for round 1, but if he can get us past round 1, we're going to go in. We're gonna push for this championship. I'm gonna do everything in my power to bring this one home. And you know, for the guys that have supported me here, the guys that have been in my front office here this season, I want to win this for you guys. You guys have had faith in me. You guys have supported the Cool Fables here this season. So I really do want to bring this one home. I want this one badly. I haven't won one in APA Wi-Fi as bad as I did this one. So hopefully we're able to bring it home, and hopefully we get that opportunity. Thank you so much again to Mid for making these slides for me. Thank you to Jacob, of course, for playing the next round for us. Hopefully he's able to pull off that dub. Be sure to drop a like, drop a comment down there in the section below. Get me hyped up for these playoff games, guys. I want to feel the love. I want to feel the love. But, guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all the support here this season. You know we're at least going to have one more video for round 1 coming to you next week. So, again, thank you guys so much for all the love and support, and we'll see you next week.